So, you know, obviously what we have seen is the threat landscape has changed, and the risks also which are there these days is much different from what it was maybe, you know, a couple of years back or maybe even a year back. And that is where we thought that yes, there was needed a paradigm shift where, you know, rather than going with the traditional approach, we have to try something very different and something very new, something which, you know, gives the CISOs the power to automate a lot of things. And that is where we thought that, you know, maybe ML and AI actually comes handy when it comes to dealing with today's threat landscape or today's cyber risk. And that is because of the awesome technology which we have, where we have the right mix of, you know, government intelligence agencies, software people from software background, and mathematicians and machine learning specialists from University of Cambridge, who all came together, you know, and basically that was how the genesis of DarkTrace was, and that is where we are providing the technology. The kind of threats which we are seeing these days is much different, you know, than what it was. Like, we are seeing more and more threats moving at machine speed. That is one thing. We are seeing more and more, you know, threats which are targeted at not just, you know, earlier it used to be only the financial gains, but nowadays the purpose of the attackers, you know, it is manifold. Like, obviously stealing data is one thing, and then selling it for financial gain is another thing. But apart from that, you know, they are also doing a lot of stuff out there, like, you know, they are manipulating data, which means it's basically more of a cyber warfare which we are seeing. So if I could give an example, like in a healthcare industry, say if the data which is manipulated is of a patient's medical record, so what can happen is it can even cause patient's death, right? So that is the kind of change in form of cyber attacks which we're seeing. And that is where we feel that yes, there has to be a new approach which needs to be adopted if one has to be ahead in this game of cyber warfare. So you don't have to look at what was last, but you have to be better prepared for what is next.
The quality of people who have joined this particular conference, so those are very informative and they are very sound. They are pretty informative and sound. And
so I think the kind of target audience which is there, because most of the people are from security background as well, so they have a very well understanding of what are the products, the technologies, and they are very well aware of what are the risks or the threats which we are seeing these days. So I think it's up to the mark, and the quality is really good. So let me just start with the pre-event, and then maybe during the event, and post-event anyways you can always talk to me and I'll let you know. So pre-event, yes, obviously the kind of the momentum which was building up, the kind of trivia which was being shared, and you know, all the content which was being shared, so that was pretty good. And I think it was very well organized, in the sense that the invitations were sent all well in time and everything was very perfect, very well organized. During the event, obviously it's altogether a very different experience. So yes, we keep attending a lot of events, but then definitely this is something which is standing apart from most of it, because one is, yes, the quality of audience which is there, very well organized, and it's an altogether a different experience. And yes, obviously, you know, the event organizers have been very supportive and very cooperative.
I would say it's an awesome event. Informative event, great audience.
Fantabulously fantastic event.